ओम श्री अरबिंदो मीरा इज माई रिफ्यूज। नमस्ते, वंदे मातरम, हर्टी वेलकम ऑल ऑफ यू। दिस मॉर्निंग द टॉपिक ऑफ द स्पिरिचुअल डिस्कशन इज ऑन कस्मिक वर्कर। वी विल हैव ए ब्रीफ डिस्कशन टुडे ऑन द कस्मिक वर्कर। द point of discussion, the gist will be how the cosmic worker prepares the instrument for the divine use, for the spiritual use. So this brilliant topic, a beautiful topic, may be a new topic for most, so we are going to discuss it in brief today. Sri Aurobindo writes here, the cosmic worker set his secret hand to turn this frail mod engine for heaven use. So there is something in opposite sequence we will feel here. The cosmic worker and the secret hand. The cosmic worker now sets his secret hand. For what? That purpose. For what he is setting his secret hand? The purpose is that to turn this frail mod engine to heaven use. This engine, this instrument is frail and mod engine. So it has to be prepared for the heaven use. So the cosmic worker comes to the front and prepares it. The mod engine whom we see for this mod engine, frail mod engine, that is the soul, that is the soul who is actually prepared. Now, initially we have known, all in him turns to spirit vastnesses. His soul breaks out to join the over soul. His life, oceaned by that super life, he has drunk from the breasts of the mother of the worlds. So just imagine how he is, for whom the cosmic worker wants to make it for heaven use, not to the original base or original instrument. The instrument is like this. His soul breaks out to join the over soul. His life is oceaned by that super life. He has drunk from the breasts of the mothers of the worlds. A topless super nature feels his frame. This is the preparation he has already prepared. And what is the initial condition? Sri Aurobindo has quoted also in couple of lines. His is a, although consenting to mortal ignorance, his knowledge shared the light of ineffable. His birth held up a symbol and a sign. His human self like a translucent cloak. This is the heaven, the mod engine whom we are playing, the cosmic worker is setting or preparing for the heaven use. Actually, his base is like this. Already he is prepared and is coming. And this instrument has been chosen. His mind was like a fire assailing heaven. His soul lived as eternity's delegate. His will, a hunter in the trials of light. Just imagine how he was, in which point of consciousness he was staying there. His was a search of darkness for the light. His was a search of darkness for the light, for finite self, for the infinity. So how this preparation is going on, how the cosmic worker is preparing the instrument for the heavenly use. The presence wrought behind the ambiguous screen. Behind the ambiguous screen, the skin is ambiguous. The presence is wrought behind presence wrought. It beat his soul. It beat his soil to bear a titan's weight. Already, Sri Aurobindo, we have in other place we have seen, this has to be prepared. This has to be already, it has to come to the point of use. It beat his soil to bear a titan's weight. Speak not my secret name to the hostile time. Man is too weak to bear the infinite's weight. Truth born so soon might break the imperfect earth. This earth is imperfect. Man is imperfect, not up to expectation. So truth born too soon, if it is kept on the imperfect earth, then the thing will break down. It will break the imperfect earth. So for that, it has to be prepared toward the heaven views. So it beat his soil to bear a titan's weight. The weight will be not ordinary weight, it will be a titan's weight. So this soil, which is used, or which is the stop of this material, the mod engine, it's this soil to bear the titan's weight. The presence was wrought, the presence was working there behind the ambiguous screen. Refining half unit blocks of material strength, it built his soul into a statued god. This is the transformation, true transformation, Sri Aurobindo speaks of. It built his soul into a statued god. Soul we have not seen, we just imagine there is a soul. There is a psychic being inside behind the heart. It is having some ambiguous presence, I mean some, it is hidden presence, hidden behind, well hidden behind the heart. It is concealed, not coming to the front. It is the divine spark. Sri Aurobindo speaks of, it built his soul into a statued god. This is the real transformation Sri Aurobindo speaks of. Even in the case of the mother, it the transformation also written. He turned her tears into the statued god, into the image of that statued god. It is written there, we have seen. Here also in case of the Lord, our master, it is written, it built his soul into a statued god. The craftsman, what does the cosmic worker, then the craftsman of the magic stuff of self, who labors at his high and difficult plan. The plan is high and the plan is also difficult. This there, the craftsman of the magic stuff of self in the wide works of the wonderful world. It is actually built inside the world only. That workshop is the existing. This workshop is too wide. Here, the craftsman, the magic secret worker, it is in planning and doing the difficult plan, and it is work in work. Modeled in inward time, his rhythmic parts, modeling, remodeling, planning, replanning, to turn soul into the statued god and to prepare this mod engine for the heaven use. And this mod engine also trial, it has to be prepared and re-prepared, saved and re-saved again and again. Then came the abrupt transcendent miracle. After this working, after this planning, up in this world laboratory, there comes the miracle. Then came the abrupt transcendent miracle. Miracle, how was that miracle? The transcendent miracle, after this planning in the hands of the transcendent worker, the cosmic worker, this transcendent miracle is happening, the abrupt transcendent miracle. The masked immaculate grandeur could outline the mask. Masked grandeur, immaculate grandeur, and masked immaculate grandeur could outline at a travel in the occult womb of life his dreamed magnificence of thing to be. Then what happens? A crown of the architecture of the worlds, a mystery of married earth and heaven, annexed divinity to the mortal scheme. So when it is prepared, it is saved, it is re-saved, it is wrought in the world's laboratory, then there comes a change. Then comes the miracle. His dreamed magnificence of thing to be. His dream, what once had been dreamed, has come to the occurrence, come to the position, it has come, been fruitful. It is has taken place, saved. A crown of the architecture of the worlds, a mystery of the married earth and heaven, annexed divinity to the mortal scheme. That into the mortal scheme, that divinity distance, and this divinity is annexed to the mortal scheme. Then what happened after these things? When it is miracle is happened, when the thing is there, when the more divinity is of annexed to the mortal scheme, then what happens? A seer was born. Another beautiful term, a seer was born, the shining guest of time, two great names, great representative, great word is used. A seer was born, a shining guest of time. Imagine shining guest of time and a seer was born. For him, thus this, for him means who, for whom, who is prepared, who is received, who is annexed divinity. For him, mind's limiting firmament seized above, no limitation. Mind's limiting firmament seized above. In the griffin forefront of the night and day, a gap was rent to the unconcealing vault. All concealing, that is concealing everything, all concealing all, there is a gap was rent. The cosmic conscious ends of being went rolling back. where we see limitation, boundaries, the limitation, the conscious ends of being went rolling back. It could not have a place, so it had to, there was no other option, it had to roll back. The landmarks of the little person fell, the littleness, the bounded, the finite things, the limitations, the landmarks of the little person fell, the island ego joined its continent. Island means water is surrounded everywhere, surrounding the sthalabhag, this land, patch of land, surrounded by the huge ocean or water. This creates a gap between the original continent and the subcontinent or the island. Island is differentiated, distinct, or keeping separated from the mainland with the water. But after this preparation by the cosmic worker or the craftsman, this ego, this island was connected its own parent continent. The island ego, there water was the dividing point, here ego was the dividing point. This ego thins and falls. Then this island joins its original continent, original land. The island ego joined its continent. Overpast was the world of rigid limiting forms. This law, this regulation, this rigidity, everything was overpassed. Now it is not there. So conscious ends went rolling back. Landmarks of the little person fell, greatness starts there. Then overpast was the world of rigid limiting forms. Island ego joins its continents. Life's barrier opened into the unknown. So when these barriers, this limitation, this bondage, this encasement, it is gone, it is broken. So what happens? Life's barriers opened into the unknown. This life's barriers were there, these limitations, it opened to the unknown. Abolished were conceptions, governance, concept from concept comes conceptions. Abolished were conceptions, governance, and the striking of subjections, rigorous clause. That clause which is rigorous, that was there, it was stricken off. Annulled the soul's treaty with nature's nescience. Annulled, it was cancelled. Because the souls had a treaty, because everywhere, in all the places, there was only the reign of nescience and all. But here, it was annulled. It was no more required. Soul has crossed the limitation. It has come to the another state, or another point, another base it has created. For this nescience, this matter, this inconscience is no more a necessary. So why is unnecessary to make a contact? So this contact with the treaty with nature's nescience was annulled. All the green inhibitions were torn off, not required. Gray inhibitions were torn off and broken the intellect's hard and lustrous lid. This intellect which possesses the hard and lustrous lid were broken down. Truth unpartitioned found immense sky room. Truth came. Don't marry this truth, see, this is the fragment of the original truth. So truth unpartitioned, here the truth can't be partitioned, undivided. This undivided truth, this true force of truth, this the original truth, this entire full truth, whole truth, found immense sky room. That what happens? An empyrean vision saw and knew. Then there comes a change, an empyrean vision saw and knew. What happens to the real change? How shall we know there is a change? What is the real output, outcome, or what is the figure we are going to observe here? The bounded mind became a boundless light. This is the real transformation. If it is coming inside the sadhaka, people who are following the track, who are in the process of the evolutionary journey, who are doing the sadhana and moving towards their destiny, the feeling will be there, the outcome they will feel. They will feel this is the change. This is the true transformation. What is going? Mind of night turns to the it will be transformed to the mind of light. The bounded mind became a boundless light. The finite self mated with the infinity. Finite becomes infinity. Bounded mind becomes the boundless life. The true transformation has come, and this cosmic worker has prepared, the craftsman has prepared his field, everything in the world's laboratory. Thank you. Vande Mataram.